I'm Paul Capozzoli, and I'm a business development engineer with Keysight Technologies. I've worked in digital design systems for over 20 years. And most recently, I've been working with customers analyzing their power distribution network designs using oscilloscopes. And at Keysight, we're constantly seeking to design better probing and analysis tools for power distribution networks. And our recent focus has been to help you to validate power distribution specs more accurately and to find faster ways to troubleshoot issues within your system design. One of the biggest challenges I have seen with power measurements recently is an explosion in the number of engineers that have designs not meeting the more stringent power rail tolerances. Frustrating because you have to spend a long time tracking down transients, noise, ripple. But are you really getting the right measurement? How can you make more accurate measurements and get your job done more quickly? Really, the fundamental question, do you know how much noise is in your DC power rails? I'd like to cover a few tips to allow you to make better power rail measurements. The real need is to be able to zoom into the millivolt level with the lowest possible probe and scope noise. It's critical to have a low noise measurement system. Tip number one, use a 1-to-1 probe and a 50 ohm input path to the scope. A 1-to-1 probe does not magnify the noise seen with a 10-to-1 probe. A 10-to-1 probe can provide as much as 90% more noise, which actually masks your actual signal you're trying to analyze. Also, the scope input termination plays a critical role in ensuring accurate measurements. A 50 ohm path is always cleaner. Ripple and noise on a DC supply are made up of small AC signals on top of a relatively large DC signal. With large DC offset and larger volts per division, the sensitivity is decreased and the scope noise relative to the small AC signal is increased, something you simply do not want. Remember, if you're using a DC block, you will inherently also block some of the low frequency AC content, keeping you from seeing the signal the way the components in your design do. Well, the tip number two is probe offset to zoom in on a small AC signal is critical. Tip number three, it's a must to use a probe with very high input impedance to minimize excess load on the circuit being tested. Anytime an oscilloscope probes the system, it becomes part of that system due to the electrical connect being made. The best approach is to use a probe which has a DC input impedance of 50 kΩ or greater, which minimizes the impact on the supply. Tip number four, have enough bandwidth. Switching currents from things like clocks and data can create high-frequency supply noise. It's recommended that your probe support a minimum of 2 GHz bandwidth. Today I tried to share a few tips. As you know, many oscilloscopes are not optimized to take full advantage of these suggestions. With Keysight's N7020A power rail probe and our very low noise S-series oscilloscope, you can see anomalies that other test tools do not display or measure. Simultaneously see FFT and time domain measurements down to the 1 millivolt per division resolution. This allows you to quickly pinpoint the source of signal interference. No other probe or scope combination in the world can do this. Thank you so much for watching.